I'm Lewis from Aspiring Gent, and I'm going to be showing you guys how to take a normal collar and turn it into a band collar easily and professionally. Now, the reason why someone might want to do this is, like I did when I bought this shirt from a bigger box store, you don't always have options to get different collars and different styles. So this is a very quick way to kind of update it, so you have a very traditional shirt, but it stands out from all the other ones on the shelf. Also, when your shirts are getting older and kind of beaten up, you can get collar stains, they can get ripped and tattered. So being able to update it and just removing it all together is another way to re-bring some life into your shirt.
So to put it simply, all you're going to be doing is taking apart the seam holding the collar on. Really simple, right? But there's two ways of doing this. The first one is going to be with a pair of scissors, and all you're going to do is what a lot of people show is cutting right along that seam. Now, that's super simple. You'll be done in 3 seconds. The thing I don't like about it, though, is it leaves a lot of fraying when you use the scissors, so I steer away from it and use the seam ripper. And all that you do with that is you pick apart the stitches holding the collar on so that you can release the collar and then stitch it all back down. Sounds super simple, right? And honestly, while doing this process, the hardest part was taking apart the collar. Now, each collar is going to be different. This is a cheaper shirt, so there's probably a lot of glue that was in there holding it down, and I didn't want to rip any of the fabric. So be very gentle and careful while taking out your stitches. It can be a pain starting off, but as you can see, once you get on a roll, it's so easy just to rip that thing apart and get on to the next stage. Now, the one thing you do want to keep in mind is making sure that you clean up the stitches very well. And as you could see in the beginning, I was in a park, so I'm going to be even extra careful not to get this all littered on the ground. But clean that up, grab your machine, and then we'll get started. I usually like to keep this at a 3 to 2.5, just so that if I need to take it apart, it won't be that hard to do. And guys, seriously, you're just stitching right that same line you took out, you're just putting it back in. You're just closing up that gap so there's no hole there, and it looks phenomenal. And as you can tell, the scissor method didn't really save that much time. Other than getting your machine set up, you're doing the same amount, but for a better quality job. Now, the one thing I didn't mess up on is I didn't talk about or show how to take off the buttons, but you just take the seam ripper and take off the thread underneath there, and you've got this thing looking magical, guys.
Hopefully that wasn't too hard for you guys, and if you found this informative or you just like watching me perform in front of the camera for you, please share this video, like, comment, let me know what I can do in other videos, and just share it all in general so that these videos can become more frequent and I can help you guys with more sewing tips. Thank you for watching and have a great day.